Daily Evening Prayer, Tuesday, October 10th, 2023. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house and the place where your honor dwells. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life. To the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the world. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt and have become abominable in their wickedness. There is none that does good. God looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any who would understand and seek after God. But they have all gone astray. They have altogether become abominable. There is none that does good. No, not one. How they know knowledge, all the workers of evil, who eat up my people as they would eat bread, and call not upon God. They were afraid where no fear was, for God has broken the bones of those who besieged you. You have put them to shame because God has rejected them. Oh, that salvation were given unto Israel out of Zion. Oh, that God would deliver his people out of captivity. Then shall Jacob rejoice, and Israel shall be glad. Save me, O God, for your name's sake, and avenge me in your strength. Hear my prayer, O God, and hearken to the words of my mouth. For the arrogant have risen up against me, and tyrants who do not have God before their eyes seek after my life. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord is he who upholds my life. He shall repay the evil of my enemies. O destroy them in your faithfulness. A freewill offering will I give you, and praise your name, O God, O Lord, because it is good. For he has delivered me out of all my trouble, and my eye has seen the ruin of my enemies. Hear my prayer, O God, and hide not yourself from my petition. Give heed to me and hear me, for I am troubled in my prayer and am tormented because of the cry of the enemy and oppression by the ungodly, for they are of a mind to do me great harm. So maliciously are they set against me. My heart is disquieted within me, and the fear of death has fallen upon me. Fearfulness and trembling have come upon me, and a horrible dread has overwhelmed me. And I said, "Oh, that I had wings like a dove, for then would I fly away and be at rest. Indeed, then I would get away to a far-off place and make my dwelling in the wilderness. I would make haste to escape because of the stormy wind and tempest. Confuse their speech, O Lord, and divide them, for I have seen unrighteousness and strife in the city. Day and night they go about within her walls. Trouble and sorrow are in the midst of her. Great wickedness is there. Deceit and guile do not leave her streets. For it is not an enemy who has done me this dishonor, for then I could have borne it. Neither was it my adversary who exalted himself against me, for then I would have hidden myself from him. But it was you, my companion, my comrade, and my own familiar friend. We took sweet counsel together and walked in the house of God as friends. Let death come hastily upon them, and let them go down alive into the grave. For there is wickedness in their hearts. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. In the evening and morning and at noonday will I pray and lament, and he shall hear my voice. It is he who shall deliver my soul in peace from the battle that is against me. For there are many who fight me. God, who endures forever, shall hear me and bring them down, for they never change, nor do they fear God. My familiar friend has laid his hands upon those who were at peace with him, and he has broken his covenant. The words of his mouth were softer than butter, yet war was in his heart. His words were smoother than oil, and yet they were drawn swords. O cast your burden upon the Lord, and he shall nourish you, and shall not allow the righteous to fall forever. But as for the bloodthirsty and deceitful, you, O God, shall bring them into the pit of destruction. They shall not live out half their lives, half their days, but my trust shall be in you, O Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of the Maccabees, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. In those days, Mattathias, son of John, son of Simeon, a priest of the family of Joarib, moved from Jerusalem and settled in Modian. He had five sons: John, surnamed Gadi, Simon, called Tassi, Judas, called Maccabeus, Eleazar, called Avaran, and Jonathan, called Apheus. He saw the blasphemies being committed in Judah and Jerusalem and said, "Alas, why was I born to see this? The ruin of my people, the ruin of the holy city, and to live there when it was given over to the enemy, the sanctuary is given over to aliens. Her temple has become like a person without honor. Her glorious vessels have been carried into exile. Her infants have been killed in her streets, her youths by the sword of the foe. One nation has not inherited her palaces, and has not seized her spoils. All her adornment has been taken away, no longer free. She has become a slave. And see, our holy place, our beauty, and our glory have been laid waste. The Gentiles have profaned them. Why should we live any longer? Then Mattathias and his sons tore their clothes and put on sackcloth and mourned greatly. The king's officers, who were enforcing the apostasy, came to the town of Modin to make them offer sacrifice. Many from Israel came to them, and Mattathias and his sons were assembled. Then the king's officers spoke to Mattathias as follows: "You are a leader, honored and great in this town, and supported by sons and brothers. Now be the first to come and do what the king commands, as all the Gentiles and the people of Judah and those who are left in Jerusalem have done. Then you and your sons will be numbered among the friends of the king, and you and your sons will be honored with silver and gold and many gifts." But Mattathias answered and said in a loud voice, "Even if all the nations that live under the rule of the king obey him and have chosen to obey his commandments, every one of them abandoning the religion of their ancestors, I, my sons, and my brothers will continue to live by the covenant of our ancestors. Far be it from us to desert the law and the ordinances. We will not obey the king's words by turning aside from our religion to the right hand or to the left." When he had finished speaking these words, a Jew came forward in the sight of all to offer sacrifice on the altar of Modin, according to the king's command. When Mattathias saw it, he burned with zeal and his heart was stirred. He gave vent to righteous anger. He ran and killed him on the altar. At the same time, he killed the king's officer who was forcing them to sacrifice, and he tore down the altar. Thus he burned with zeal for the law, just as Phinehas did against Zeran, son of Salu. Then Mattathias cried out in the town with a loud voice, saying, "Let everyone who is zealous for the law and supports the covenant come out with me." Then he and his sons fled to the hills and left all that they had in the town. At that time, many who were seeking righteousness and justice went down to the wilderness to live there, they, their sons, their wives, and their livestock, because troubles pressed heavily upon them. And it was reported to the king's officers and to the troops in Jerusalem, the city of David, that those who had rejected the king's command had gone down to the hiding places in the wilderness. Many pursued them and overtook them. They encamped opposite them and prepared for battle against them on the Sabbath day. They said to them, "Enough of this. Come out and do what the king commands, and you will live." But they said, "We will not come out, nor will we do what the king commands and so profane the Sabbath day." Then the enemy quickly attacked them, but they did not answer them or hurl a stone at them or block up their hiding places, for they said, "Let us all die in our innocence. Heaven and earth testify for us that you are killing us unjustly." So they attacked them on the Sabbath, and they died with their wives and children and livestock, to the number of 1,000 persons. When Mattathias and his friends learned of it, they mourned for them deeply, and all said to their neighbors, "If we all do as our kindred have done and refuse to fight the Gentiles for our lives and for our ordinances, they will quickly destroy us from the earth." So they made the decision that day, "Let us fight against anyone who comes to attack us on the Sabbath day. Let us not all die as our kindred died in their hiding places." Then there united with them a company of Hasidians, mighty warriors of Israel, all who offered themselves willingly for the law, and all who became fugitives to escape their troubles joined them and reinforced them. They organized an army and struck down sinners in their anger and renegades in their wrath. The survivors fled to the Gentiles for safety, and Mattathias and his friends went around and tore down the altars. They forcibly circumcised all the uncircumcised boys that they found within the borders of Israel. They hunted down the arrogant, and the work prospered in their hands. They rescued the law out of the hands of the Gentiles and kings, and they never let the sinner gain the upper hand. Now the days drew near for Mattathias to die, and he said to his sons, "Arrogance and scorn have now become strong. It is a time of ruin and furious anger. Now, my children, show zeal for the law and give your lives for the covenant of our ancestors. Remember the deeds of the ancestors which they did in their generations, and you will receive great honor and an everlasting name. Was not Abraham found faithful and tasted, and it was reckoned to him as righteousness? Joseph, in the time of his distress, kept the commandment and became lord of Egypt. Phinehas, our ancestor, became, because he was deeply zealous, received the covenant of everlasting priesthood. Joshua, because he fulfilled the command, became a judge in Israel. Caleb, because he testified in the assembly, received an inheritance in the land. David, because he was merciful, inherited the throne of the kingdom forever. Elijah, because of great zeal for the law, was taken up into heaven. Hananiah, Azariah, and Mishael believed and were saved from the flame. Daniel, because of his innocence, was delivered from the mouth of the lions. And so observe from generation to generation that none of those who put their trust in him will lack strength. Do not fear the words of sinners, for their splendor will turn into dung and worms. Today they will be exalted, but tomorrow they will not be found, because they will have returned to the dust, and their plans will have perished. My children, be courageous and grow strong in the law, for by it you will gain honor. Here is your brother Simeon, who I know is wise in counsel. Always listen to him. He shall be your father. Judas Maccabees has been a mighty warrior from his youth. He shall command the army for you and fight the battles against the peoples. You shall rally around you all who observe the law and avenge the wrong done to your people. Pay back the Gentiles in full and obey the commands of the law. Then he blessed them and was gathered to his ancestors. He died in the 146th year and was buried in the tomb of his ancestors at Modin. And all Israel mourned for him with great lamentation. Here ends the reading. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts. Then let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, beginning with the 26th chapter, the 57th verse. Those who had arrested Jesus led him away to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the scribes and the elders were gathered together. But Peter was following him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and he came inside and sat down with the officers to see the outcome. Now the chief priests and the entire council kept trying to obtain false testimony against Jesus, so that they might put him to death. They did not find any, even though many false witnesses came forward. But later on, two came forward and said, "This man said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and to rebuild it in 3 days.'" The high priest stood up and said to him, "Do you offer no answer for what these men are testifying against you?" But Jesus kept silent, and the high priest said to him, "I place you under oath by the living God to tell us whatever you are. To tell us whether you are the Christ, the Son of God." Jesus said to him, "You have said it yourself, but I tell you, from now on you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his robes and said, Yes, blasphemed. What further need do we have of witnesses? See, you have now heard the blasphemy. What do you think? He answered him, He deserves death. Then they spit in his face and beat him with their fists. And others slapped him and said, Prophesy to us, you Christ, who is the one who hit you. Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard, and a slave woman came to him and said, You too were with Jesus, the Galilean. But he denied it before them all, saying, I do not know what you are talking about. When he had gone out to the gateway, another slave woman said to him and said to those who were there, This man was with Jesus of Nazareth. And again he denied it with an oath, I do not know the man. A little later, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, You really are one of them as well, since even the way you talk gives you away. Then he began to curse and swear, I do not know the man. And immediately a rooster crowed. And Peter remembered the statement that Jesus had made, Before a rooster crows, you will deny me three times. And he went out and wept bitterly. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things and the rich he has sent in to obey. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord, that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. Keep, O Lord, your household, the church, in continual godliness, that through your protection it may be free from all adversities and devoutly serve you in good works, to the glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, and give rest to the weary. Bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous. All for your love's sake. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, that we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your one beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever.